Hello friends, this is the first lecture on the systolic arrays. This is, as we can say, first lecture of the series of the systolic arrays, in which we have to explain the working of systolic arrays. Systolic arrays are basically hardware architectures for parallel processing, and we will see that how these systolic arrays work work for the multiplication of 3x3 matrices. So here are, we can say, two different, we can say, architectures inside the, we can say, systolic arrays. This type of structure which is here, in this architecture we can see that this processing element will pass the input that is given from the above to the downward after a clock cycle. Similarly, this input will be propagated to the right side after one clock cycle, and similarly after another clock cycle, this input for this processing element will be on this place. And similarly, after, we can say, four clock cycles, we will have this input as the output of this processing element, and similarly. So this processing element can have multiple, we can say, options, or we can say this processing element must have configurable parameters. So in this case, we assume that this processing element will multiply these both and will add to the previous result, and it will keep on adding up to the clocks that we are providing, clock cycles, up to the clock cycles and inputs, outputs, ends. So in this case, we can say it is a multiplier and accumulator unit at this place. And if you don't understand how this processing element is, we can say, working, so this is another basic structure that shows that this processing element just, we can say, have a limited type of application. It has three inputs and three outputs, okay, and the vertical input will be available as an output, same output, after a clock cycle. Similarly, the horizontal input will be the output after the same clock cycle, but the diagonal input will be added to the multiplication of horizontal and vertical input. So in this case, we can say that at this place we will have an important output, that is the multiplication of horizontal and vertical inputs, and the, we can say, addition with the previous value. So in this case, we will move forward. So the delay element will just pass the value to the next place, downward or left side, right side, sorry, after one clock cycle. So that is, we can say, the game we are going to play. So in the next slide, we can see there are two matrices, A and B, and C is the output. So C is the output, which is the multiplication of A and B, and here we have multiplied it that we are using this multiplication rule from the elementary classes. So now we have to apply this multiplication on the systolic arrays. So for this multiplication, we need first row of A and first column of B in the first clock cycle. And similarly, on the other next clock cycles, we need second row, second column, third row, third column, and so on. And after the first row, first column, second row, third column are ended, we will give no output, no inputs, and the inputs will be zero. The outputs will be calculated depending upon the values given at the input. So let us start from the first clock cycle. In this clock cycle, we have to first re-explain this processing element. See, at previous clock cycle, we can say T of n minus 1. We will have three inputs here, A, B, and C. And after the clock cycle ends, on the next clock cycle, we will have B over here. B will be moved downward. A will be moved rightward. And C will be moved to the diagonal side. But it will be added to the multiplication of A and B. So the rule is, just move A to the right side, B to the downside, and we have to just add C with A and B. We can say A and B, or A multiplied by B. So this is our, we can say, main working of processing element. So if you apply this multiplication, we can say, rule over here, we can see that after one clock cycle, these five values, this is the first row of A, will be moved at this place. A11 will be here, A12 will be here, A13 will be here, and 0 will be here, and 0 will be here. Similarly, after one clock cycle, B11 will be here, B21 will be here, B31 will be here, and 0 will be here, and 0 will be here. So we can say that this is first row of A, and this is first column of A, that we have studied in the elementary classes, that how to multiply two matrices, first row and first column. First row of A, first matrix, and second row of second matrix. First column of second matrix. So now we have decided this value and this value. We can say we have decided the vertical values and horizontal values of the next clock cycle. But now we have to calculate the diagonal values. So in this case, the first diagonal value here will be 0, because 0 will be added to the A13 into nothing here. And similarly, here will also be 0, because 0 will be added to A12 into 0. And here will be 0 plus A11 B1. This will be our first result here, A11 B11. And similarly, here we will get 0, here we will get 0. So we should move on the next clock cycle to see our calculated results are okay or not. We have calculated 0 here, 0 here. Here we have calculated A11, B11. And here we have calculated 0 and 0. So see, here is 0, here is 0, here is A11, B11. Here is our 0 and 0. And next row of A have been given at the input, with, we can say, one shift, downward shift. Similarly, next column of B is given as input with one right shift, and the previous value of B has been moved on the next place. Similarly, the previous value of A has been moved on the next place. And this is the result of, we can say, first clock cycle ends and the second clock cycle begins. So next we can estimate that this will be these A11, B12, so A11, A12, A13, and so on. They will be moved on the next place. Here they will be moved on the next place, and so on. Similarly, on the above side, we can have B11, B21, B31 will be moved downward. And similarly, on the next clock cycle, these values will be shifted and moved downward. And for these places, we can say, Here we can expect 0 at this place on the next cycle. We can expect 0 because 0, all three inputs are 0. And similarly, here we can get A11, B12 because 0 is here and A11 and B12 will be multiplied and added to the 0. And here is will be 0 because here is 0 multiplied by 0, B11, B22, so that will be 0. Similarly, here we can have 0, no, not 0, I am wrong. Here we can have A21, B11, we can have A21, B11 here, and we can have 0 here. So let's check. Another thing we have to see on the next, we can say, level, we can check. Here, what should be the result? The result should be A11, B11 plus A12, B21. Am I right? A11, B11 plus A12, B21. Because here we can see a C plus AB. These two inputs will be multiplied and added to the C. So these two inputs will be multiplied and added to the C, and they will give us the result over here. So we have to see what is the result. This is the result. This is the third clock cycle in which we got C plus on this place. C plus, what is C plus? C plus is equals to A11, B11, the previous C, and A and B will be multiplied and they will be given, they will be added to the previous C value, and this will give us the result. And similarly, all other values that we have calculated before are appeared here after the clock cycle. So we can say change has been happened. Another change is that third row is given as input, and B, third column of B is given as input, and all other columns of B are shifted downward. And similarly, when third row is given as input, the other rows of A are moved to the right, and these inputs are given with a shift of 0 to the downside, and these inputs are given as a shift to the right side. So this is the requirement of hardware. We have to shift one step downward. You see, here was first row, and then second row, and second column shifted to the second row is shifted to the downside, and second column is shifted to the right side. And similarly, this is third row shifted downward one step, and here the third column shifted right side one step. And similarly, we have calculated other values of the we can say C. Now, what should be the next clock cycle? In next clock cycle, we can have this C plus will be added to A13 and B31. Okay. Already C plus, what is C plus? C plus is A11, B11, and we can say A12, B21. So they are added together with A13 and B31. So this will give us the result. Okay. So now we have to recalculate the, we can say, for understanding, we can say we have to recalculate the value of the C on this place for the next clock cycle. So what should be the value? It should be 0 because all three inputs are 0. Similarly, here the input output should be 0 because all three inputs are 0. Here what should be? Here should be the output. It should be A11, B13. And similarly, here what should be the output? It should be 0. And here what should be the output? It should be A31, B11. And other, there are no outputs on these places. Another output, we have discussed this output before. And we can say what should be the output here? It should be A21, B11. Sorry, we have to move to the previous slide. A21, B11, and plus A22, B21. And similarly, what should be the output over here? It should be A11, B12, and A12, B22. And we can check what are the outputs. Outputs are there, the same outputs that we have calculated before. And these are, we can say, written here for just, we can say, symbols C plus and C minus. So that we cannot rush all the values over here. So here is our first result, C11, after the 4 clock cycles. But this will be not at the output. Output is accumulated over here. So this will reach after 2 clock cycles and the output. So in this way, we will during this process, we can also calculate these values. C minus minus will be added to B A13 and B32, and it will give us, we can say, C12. It will give us C12 on this place on the next clock cycle, and similarly, it will give us C21 on the next clock cycle, and similarly, this will give us A31, B11. Plus A32, B21, and similarly, all other values will be calculated. So, moving to the next clock cycle, we have got these outputs. We can say not the outputs. These we can say calculated values on these diagonal places. Okay, using the same rule that we have seen on the first clock cycle and second clock cycle, and moving to the next clock cycle, we can see that this will be output, this will be output, this will be the output, and here we will get another output, C steric plus A13 B33. What is C steric? C steric is A11 B13 plus A12 B23 plus A13 B33. That will complete our output here also, and also another output here will be calculated. C positive will be added to the A33 and B31, and it will give us the output at this place. So we can we are expecting 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 complete outputs on the next clock cycle. So C, we have got the 5 outputs on this clock cycle, 6 clock cycle. We have calculated these. So they are our outputs. So on the next clock cycle, we can have we can apply the same rule, and we can see the values that was given for the input. We can say rows of A, they are propagating and they are going out to the output sides, we can say. And similarly, B is moving downward on each clock cycle. Okay, we can see from the previous way. This is A. This is A11. It is here, A11. Then again, A11 is here, A11 is here, A11 is here. And at 6th clock cycle, it is out of the circle. Okay, and we can follow the same pattern for the other values or other rows and columns of A and B. So now again we can see we will have this output on the next clock cycle over here. Here what will be the output? Here it will be A31 B13 plus A32 B23 we will get here. And similarly, this this place will have the output C positive plus A23 B33. And similarly, we will have 0 output here, and we will have here what should be C minus plus A33B23. This will give us another output, and we are expecting three outputs. Here will be 0, here will be our, we can say, C32, and here will be our value C22, and here will be our value C23, and here will be our value 0. So we have expected three outputs on the next clock cycle. There are three outputs, C32, C22, and C23. And we have calculated almost 3 plus 5, 8 outputs out of 9. So in the last clock cycle, we will have this output, which will be C minus plus A33B33 will give us C33. So here is our 8th clock cycle, and here is our result. So this was just I have tried my best to explain in simple way and demonstrate in simple way. And if you have pencil and paper, you can do it on your own on the paper, and it will give you more understanding. So this systolic array have calculated 3x3 multiplication. We can move before. We have calculated 3x3 multiplication in just 9 clock cycles. 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th, 8th, and 8th. We can say, we have calculated all the values in 8 clock cycles. All the multiplication results of the systolic array. Or we can say 8 clocks or 8 steps, we can say. So this was an interactive way of calculating. And in next video, we will be working on 2D convolution using the systolic arrays. And I will see you in the next video. Okay, thanks.